Injecting a language or expression into our code makes it easier to read and gives us additional access to tools such as syntax highlighting and checking. Let's inject JSON into this string with Option and Enter on Mac or Alt and Enter for Windows and Linux, and select Inject Language or Reference. Now we can search for JSON. We can see that the syntax highlighting changes, and we also get a prompt to say that JSON was temporarily injected. Because it's temporary at this stage, if we deleted this code element, the language injection would also be deleted. We can use Option and Enter or Alt and Enter again to add the language annotation, making the language injection permanent for this code element. Now we have injected JSON, we can see at the ends of lines 13 and 14 are underlined in red, meaning it's not currently valid JSON. We need to fix that by adding a comma. How about this string on line 19? Let's inject HTML into that, so we can see the tags more clearly. We won't use a permanent language annotation for this one, so we'll press escape. Finally, what about this method? On line 22, it uses a regular expression to validate a phone number is of a specific format. Three numbers, followed by a hyphen, followed by four numbers. Let's use the same shortcut again, Option and Enter for Mac or Alt and Enter on Windows and Linux, and select Inject Language or Reference. Now, let's search for regular expression. Let's use the same shortcut again, now we've injected regular expression, and this time scroll down to Check Regular Expression. Now in our sample field, we can type in a few invalid phone numbers. See that it doesn't pass the regular expression. Now, let's type in a valid phone number. And good, it passes. Finally, we can also uninject a language or reference using the same shortcut again. So Option and Enter on Mac or Alt and Enter on Windows and Linux and select Uninject Language or Reference. If you do remove a language or reference, it's a good idea to re-optimize your imports. You can do this with Control Option and O on Mac or Control Alt and O on Windows and Linux. I'm not going to do that.